first, Dr. Popko had detailed the sensitive instruments he would be adhering to every part of Charlie's body. Electrodes on his temples, temperature monitors on his fingertips, sensitive ribbons that detected endocrine levels and pupil dilation, and the presence of fright fluids in the brain. Most of this equipment was concealed under a loose-fitting black t-shirt and pants that, like most of Charlie's clothes, were dark and sack-like in nature. The three abandoned the van in a lot outside of the city and reached the center of Barsana by rickshaw. Kimber was aware of the strange scene their figures cut in this place of vitality. A broad-shouldered office type with a suspicious eye and an enormous jaw. A white-haired man in a blindfold and black clothes that made him look like a kidnapped busboy. And a pale woman with striped hair and equally gloomy clothes who chose to wear combat boots in 80-degree heat. The three were death warmed over. A holy trinity of poor health and misguided life choices. The village of Barsana was small, with many winding roads. Stone buildings, 1 to 2 stories tall, were covered in peeling murals advertising foods, perfumes, and government-sponsored bang, the cannabis milkshake guzzled for this festival. As the rickshaw slowed, Kimber noticed that the circles of men drinking bang were exactly that. Men, not women. Men with faces as dark and severe as raisins. Many of them accepted their drinks without smiling, sucking down each steaming green label in one gulp to prove something Kimber could not name. The women would still be inside at this hour, putting the finishing touches on the elaborate meals their families would eat over the course of the day. With every minute that passed, the storefronts and their lazing proprietors were concealed by gangs of wide-eyed men. Grandmothers prowled arm in arm. Musicians armed with battery-powered amps started sing-alongs. People were kissing, touching, in a cloud of fennel and hair oil. They leaned over corner stalls to buy bags of poppy pink and pansy, pumpkin, indigo, and teal. Colors of fire and corn chips. Colors that did not exist until the 1960s. Synthesized colors with fluorescing agents to glow against umber skin. It was only 10 a.m., but people were already covered in paint. Men with heads turned black and green like corpses. Women with tangerine smiles. The official festivities began at dusk. Popko had rented half of a storefront near the center of town. A man selling potato slices, saris, and sunglasses had set out 3 folding chairs for the guests. The rickshaw was slowing. As Popko waved to a man in the street, Kimber felt the daylight changing. The steady yellow light that bathed the people was going gray. The rich blue of the sky was going gray. A flicker here and there, accompanied by a feverish sensation, just like what she had felt on the plane.